Creating seamless repeating patterns can be a little bit of a challenge in Canva, but we're going to be able to do it in today's video. I'm going to show you how to create two different patterns. It's going to be simple. So log into your Canva and follow along. And remember that you can use anything to create repeating patterns. You can use shapes, you can use color, you can use text. You can even use your own logo. You know, you can use it for anything. You can use it for background images in your social media, on your website, right? Many uses for repeating patterns. So let's jump right on in and let's get started. So in the Canva dashboard, we're going to create a custom size. So let's do a 2000 by 2000 just for this example. But if you're going to use it for maybe like a repeating pattern for products, 4500 by 4500 is a great size, but whichever size you select, it does need to be a square in order for the repeating patterns to look good. Okay, so let's go into our element and let's do a birthday cake. So let's take a look at all of the different birthday cakes. For simplicity's sake, we're gonna go ahead and pick this birthday cake here. It's nice and simple. Let's make that black so we can really see it. All right, so the first step for creating pattern is offsetting the images that are around the border, okay? So let's begin with the top hand corner here. What we want to show is only a quarter of the design, okay? So this is you, I just want this corner here. So how you accomplish that is that you grab the element and you are going to come to the left. If you take a look at here and this area here, you're going to see a purple line appear. All right, do you see that? All right, so that means that this element is right in the center. Then you're gonna bring it up and then you're going to bring it so it's in the center horizontally and vertically. So you can just go slowly until you find it should be right there. Okay, so you see those two lines on the top and the left. Okay, so that means that a quarter of the design is showing. And then we're going to do the same thing on all four corners. So you can either copy and paste the design, or you can also click and hold the Alt key. Then you click on the item that you want to duplicate and then drag it down and it'll create a duplicate for you. All right, so that may take a little bit of trial and error, but you will see the lines will line up. And of course, you can always come back and make adjustments if you need to. So now what we're going to do, I'm going to grab this and I'm going to make a pattern in the center here. So I want this right slap in the middle of the design. So you can either move around until you have those lines come across, as you see there. Okay. Then I'm going to go ahead and make another copy and I want one maybe right here. Now I want these to be lined up. So what you can do is you can highlight them both. You go to position and then click on middle and it'll align those elements to the middle of each other. So you grab this one and this one, same thing middle here. And then we already know that this one is already in the center. So what you can do is I already have these selected. So I'm gonna press and hold the shift, select these four here. And then I'm going to move these to make sure that they're in the middle of the design. You see how that line comes across there in the middle? And then we're going to move it around and make sure right there. You see that? You see how those, the crosshairs, I guess you call those? All right. And then I'm going to add two more. Also, if you don't see the line, you see where it says 415, it's telling you that that is the same distance as the one all the way to the right. So that is one way that you know that the distance is exactly the same. Then you can move it down so you have all three lines. So I'm going to move it again so you can see this. You're going to see three lines appear, one here, one in the center, and one toward the bottom. All right, do you see how it's the solid line right in the middle of the center? That means that design is centered there. Okay. Another way you can do it is, again, you can grab all three of them, go to position, and center them there as well. Okay. And then we're going to do the same thing, top and bottom. All right, so that should be a good repeating pattern. I'm going to do a second one just for demonstration purposes. So I'm going to grab this one, I'm going to copy and paste it into this design here. And depending on the type of pattern that you're looking for, you can make these whatever size you want that to be. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing. I'm only almost going to create like a tile. All right, there we go. So now we have two patterns to work with. Now, depending on what you want to use this repeating pattern for, will determine what your next step is going to be. So I'm going to show you two things that normally my clients use the repeating patterns for. So one is to add it to a product, and the second one is for social media. So let's go ahead and do a product demonstration for you. So we're going to download both images. We're going to click on share, and we're going to just download it. PNG is perfectly fine, and we want both images. So let's download those images here. Because it's two images, it's going to create a zip file. So we'll go ahead and just unzip it. And then let's head over to Printify. If you've never seen Printify before, Printify is a print-on-demand company where you can upload your designs and you can sell a variety of different products. Okay, so the one that I'm looking for today so that I can show you the pattern that we've just created and how it would look, it's called a all-over print, okay? So that's what we're looking for. So I'm going to go ahead and use this plush blanket to add the design to. So let's start designing here. I'm going to upload the first image. Here we are, our first repeating pattern. So I'm just going to bring it over here to the corner here. And then I'm going to click right here for pattern. And there we go. That is the result of our repeating pattern. Now, if you want to go ahead and make some adjustments, you can certainly go back to Canva and make those adjustments as you want, and then upload them to wherever you want to upload them. So now let's try the second design. All right, so we're going to do the same thing. We're going to go to the device, and we're going to upload the second one. And we only did it in the four corners, right? So let's bring this up here, and let's do the same thing. And this is what it would look like. Okay, perfect. So now let's go back into Canva. If you want to use the repeating patterns or designs that you are creating in Canva, you have two options. You can either upload the design that we just downloaded. So now you have it here and you can use it just like this. So you would just have to copy and paste so you can make your repeating pattern. That's one option there. The other option is in the design here, you can go into projects. Your design, your latest design will be right here. So you can click on it and then it'll have all of the pages that are in that design and you can select which one you want to use. You can apply both or you can just do one. So I'm going to select this one here. And now because you're bringing it in from within a Canva design, each one will be by itself. It'll be individual elements. So if you want to create smaller patterns, so what you can do is you can highlight them all and then group it so it's one design. And then you can resize and make those repeating patterns however you want to use those repeating patterns. And there you go. Now, this concept applies to any type of repeating designs that you want to create, whether it's elements of all different sizes and colors, it's the same concept. So I'm going to go ahead and create one for you. So sit back, relax, and watch. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Now, don't forget that Canva does offer pre-made patterns already for you. So head over to Elements and type in patterns and you'll have a wealth of patterns that you can choose from to get you started. So again, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please consider giving me a thumbs up and subscribing for more videos like this. Until next time, my friend, adios.